The man has a passion for intergalactic things. Back then, people were obviously scared of the Russian atomic bomb, but an invasion by extraterrestrials was a legit fear as well. Seems like the mechanic had made his choice. Roswell, Atamipec, same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies. Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves? If some daring person could manage to get their hands on the missing parts, Carl was willing to bet that the craft would have taken flight. These scribblings were undoubtedly the mark of a tormented mind. Something wasn't right in the poor mechanic's head. Thank you. hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands. By following the plan, Carl was led to believe that the snowmobile's parts had to be scattered about in the vicinity. Seems like the elements showed mercy to those nice and solid-looking planks. Carl had no idea how to interpret a message like that. On the surface, it seemed like he had one half too many of this puzzle. Enough to know he shouldn't take this testimony as gospel. The entire thing, being some punishment for a murder committed by Hamilton, seemed like an outlandish theory. Carl was doubtful. Carl still wasn't done with the mechanic's place. A bit of gas, a new spark plug, and a key, and this thing would run perfectly. All he needed to do now was to find all that. Carl felt that it was mission accomplished, with the wicked nectar in his hands. Thank you.
Слухай, блін, мені.
О, като шершу трув. Parce que je t'aime bien, Astor, je vais te dire quelque chose. Tu fais bien de prendre ma pélisse. Parce que par là-bas, tu vas rencontrer le vrai froid. Un froid qui glace comme t'en as jamais connu dans ta vie.
Old man's cabin had been very generous to Carl. He couldn't have asked for more. A steak alone cannot subdue a starving stomach. An appetite comes with eating. That large antenna in the middle of the path, undoubtedly ideal in attempting to communicate with little green men, was quite awkwardly placed. There had to be a lever to control it, maybe behind it. Carl would have to figure out how to reach it. The electric terminals appeared to be linked together, but for what purpose? So that's where the generator key was hiding. All that was left was to use it.
Thank you.
Carl rejoiced at the unexpected source of heat, but not as much as his freezing hands.
Thank you.
open sesame. At last, so big an effort for an oh-so-tiny piece of metal.